Hello students, I'm your SST faculty at Excellence. So today we are going to discuss about the merits and demerits of democracy. So let's start. So as we have discussed about what is democracy and the features of democracy, right? So now we are going to discuss the merits of democracy. Okay, so here you can see the first merit of democracy is a democratic government is a better government because it is a more accountable form of government, right? So the first point is democratic form of government is more accountable to people. So in China, during 1958 to 1961, there was a great famine where a lot of people, around 3 crore people, died due to hunger. Okay, there was a food scarcity, right? But if you compare India during that time, due to the policy by the government, the India basically they can provide food to the people due to their right policies. So they actually fight against the food scarcity due to democracy. Because we know that in democracy, people sit and discuss about a particular topic, discuss about a particular event, and they find the solution from the various person. Okay, but in China, as you can see, there was no opposition party, there was no media coverage, right? So that is why the China couldn't tackle the famine. The next merit of democracy is it improves the quality of decision making, right? So it improves the quality of decision making. How? As you can see in the picture, okay, there was a teamwork going on, right? So in a democracy, we also have to work with a team, right? We have to consult. We have to consult different people to take a decision, right? So that is why we can get a better decision, right? Or we can say the quality of decision making maintained in democracy. Okay. Now see the next merit. So democracy provides a method to deal with differences and conflicts. So as we know, in every organization, in every society, there is a different people in terms of religion, in terms of language, right? So everyone has a different perspective. For example, his perspective may not be matched with this man's perspective, right? So democracy basically help to maintain a unity. How? Because as we know, for example, if we give some privileges to one particular party, then may the other party will protest, right? So democracy, as democracy maintain the equality, right? Equality. So that is how democracy can help it can provide to deal with differences and conflict. Okay, the democracy can resolve those conflicts as it concentrated on equality, right? Okay, so let's understand the next merit of democracy, which is it enhances the dignity of citizen. Okay, so how it enhances the dignity of citizen? Through providing political equality. That means irrespective of caste, irrespective of gender, irrespective of class, every section of society can give vote. Okay, every citizen can participate in voting system. Okay, so that is how it maintains the dignity of all citizens, irrespective of caste, class, gender. Okay, so now let's move on the next merit of democracy, which is democracy allows us to correct its own mistakes, right? If you do mistakes in democracy, it cannot be hidden for long, right? So in next 5 years, the ruling party may be replaced by the other party, right? Why? Due to some bad decisions. Okay, So that is how in a democracy it allows us to correct its own mistakes. Okay, because as we know, in democracy we have this space of public discussions, right? We have this space of that people can participate, people can express their views about particular decisions, right? So that is how it can correct their mistakes. Okay, so that was the merits of democracy, right? So now we will see the demerits of democracy. Okay, so here you can see, so first one is leaders keep changing in democracy, which leads to instability. Okay, so leaders keep changing in democracy. So as we know in democracy that in every 5 years there is an election. Okay, that means changing of the leader. Okay, so that changing leaders may lead to instability. For example, if a particular government makes some policies for the citizens, right? So after 5 years, for example, some other government came, okay, other government or other party came into the power, then he might not give interest to that particular policy. Okay, so that leads to instability, right? So the second point is democracy is all about political competition and power play. Okay, so in a democracy, as we can see, it is all about the competition between various parties, that who are going to be in the power. So as we compare it with the other form of government, for example, in a monarchy form of government, there people know, or the particular king also know that he will become the king, or particular son also know that he will become the king. But in democracy, no one will know earlier that who are going to be the leader, right? So there is always a competition between various parties, right? Okay, so the next point is, so many people have to be consulted in a democracy that leads to delay. Okay, as we know that in democracy we have to, or the leaders have to consult with the other member. Okay, the leaders have to consult with the other member for a decision, right? To take a decision in democracy, which may lead some delay in decision making process. Okay, so that is another demerits of democracy. So there are some other demerits of democracy. For example, it may lead to bad decisions sometimes. Why? Because the elected leaders do not know the best interest of the people, right? Sometimes the elected leader were more concentrated on the what? Competition, right? On the competition. So they sometimes miss out the interest of the people, and that leads to protest, as we can see in various part of our country, right? So sometimes it may lead to bad decision. Okay, so the next point is democracy leads to corruption, as it is based on the electoral competition, right? So as we know that in our country election take place in every 5 years, right? So if there is election in every 5 years, that means the campaigning will happen, right? Competition will happen. Okay, so corruption in campaigning may exist, corruption in electoral process may exist, right? So democracy sometimes leads to corruption, as it is based on the electoral competitions, right? Okay, so we have discussed about some merits and demerits of democracy, right? So now you have to understand one important concept called representative democracy, right? So what is representative democracy? As we all know that representative means it is a person whom we choose, and he will do his work on behalf of our choice. Okay, For example, in your school also, okay, in your school also, you have school representative, okay, school representative, and he will basically, become a mediator of you and the principal. Okay, so he basically took permission on behalf of the whole class, right? So that is how in our country also we have some representative who basically will take some decisions on behalf of us or on behalf of our citizen, right? So why we use the representative democracy? Because it is not possible to exercise the direct democracy, right? Because in direct democracy, every individual need to participate in the decision making process in a government. Okay, so direct democracy is what, where people, all the people participate, and they can make their point of view, they can express their point of view, right? So if we see in a society or in our country, not all the people are skilled or educated, right? So we cannot take everyone's decisions. So we follow the representative democracy, right? Where we choose one particular representative to basically express on behalf of our wish, right? Okay. Now, as we have understood what is democracy, what are the features of democracy, and what are various merits and demerits of democracy, now we will see a broader meaning of democracy, right? So in a broader meaning of democracy, we can include democracy in family. Okay, so what is the meaning of democracy in family? For example, in a family, okay, if everyone's decisions are given value, that family will call the democratic family, right? Where everyone's decision, irrespective of their gender, right, they have some choice, they have some, their decisions are valued by every person in the family member, right? Okay, so as you can see in your screen that this is a classroom, right? So we can say that democracy in classroom, that means class, democratic classroom. So democratic classroom means where the teacher will concentrate all on giving the knowledge on the basis of equality. The main goal of the teacher is to deliver knowledge to the all the students, right? Okay, so I hope you have understood what I'm trying to say. Okay, so another example of democracy, you can say Gram Sabha. As you can see, there are a lot of people who are sitting and discussing about maybe some matter of their village, maybe some problems of their village, right? So as you can see, there is a female, there are male, so everyone is participating in decision making, right? So in Gram Sabha also we can see democracy, that means democratic village, we can simply say that. Okay, so that was the broader concept of democracy that we can see in everyday life, or we can, you know, give example from village, from organization, from family, right? So that was it. I hope you have understood. Thank you so much.